Yo, what's up, man?
Coolin', man.
You know what I want to hear, right?
What you want to hear?
Baby!
Hey, welcome to another edition of the Buffet Boys. This is installment number 56. You know who it is. It's your main man. The one you're always waiting for every single week. The Salvadoran sensation, Eb. And as always with me, it's my main man, 100 grand. The hotel hustler himself. Mr. Kodak Brown. Mr. 32 Savage. Mr. Stoyo Girl gave her right back. We've already gone over this. Don't act surprised. Don't act like you didn't know what was going on. I told you from the jump, I don't do Valentine's Day. The best import coming out of Mexico. Post Malone, number one fan.
Come on.
You know him best as the Dutch Dynamo. Vic, what's going on, Vic? What's popping?
Yo, man, what's going on, man?
Yeah, you know they say it's me.
You're going to use that joke every week now?
Every time.
Every time I set you up for it, huh?
Every time I'm slamming it.
Alley-oop, oh, man.
Windmill dunkaroo.
Hey, man. Hey.
What's going on, young one?
I had something interesting happen to me today, man.
Tell me. What happened to you?
So, before we get into the show, man. So I went to the gym with my brother, right?
Yeah.
And I went through the locker room, right? And as soon as I walked in, there was some dude walking in from the other side. And it was some normal-ass, regular white guy. Okay. Just trying to get his pump in, right? So,
chill. Relax.
Hold on. Pause.
Let's rip. Backtrack.
That's not
backtrack,
what I meant.
Backtrack.
That's
listen.
Not what I meant.
This ain't no Marlon Brando, Richard Pryor story.
Oh,
chill out.
No. Anyway, so I'm walking through. And as I'm walking, I see this guy, what looks to me like throwing gang signs at me.
Oh,
I'm thinking
shit.
I'm getting banged on over here. And okay. I'm just like, what? Whoa. Hold on. What is going on here, sir? And as I'm walking up, Eb, I realize that he's throwing up the W. And I'm like, oh, that's right. I'm wearing my Wu-Tang shirt today.
And I
don't know, man. Like, it went from being like, kind of nervous to being like, God damn, had to run into a corny ass regular white guy, but I just kind of give him like ha ha and just walk by
it. just kept it pushing.
I had a workout to get in, man.
Listen, man, I would have hoped that you would have gotten banged on instead of that. That was a corny ass story to even be involved in. I'm like, hey, listen, I don't know what part of town you're from. But where I'm from, what you just did right now, sure enough will get you shanked.
It's a violation. It's a violation.
Take your shoes and your shirt. Well, I'm glad you didn't get banged on by a white boy, because you would have had your card revoked immediately.
Oh, come on.
Immediately. Well.
Anyway, man, how you doing, man?
I'm doing good, man. Hey, listen. Valentine's Day is, well, when this comes out, it'll be one day, and, you know, I'm married now. I don't have to really worry about it too much, you know, we keep it low-key and easy-breezy. I think the only time people have to worry about Valentine's Day is when you're within that honeymoon first-year phase where it's like, shit, we gotta go to this fucking whack-ass restaurant that's gonna cost me at least $2.
Not me.
With a prefixed menu.
Not me.
Yeah, not you. We know you. Listen, we know you. We know who you are. We know Frugal Guerrero. He ain't going nowhere. And I admire you, Vic, because you don't switch up for no one. You don't care. You don't give a shit. And I think that's the way you're supposed to be. Listen, you're going to love me for me. You're going to love me for my heart, not what I can give you.
Right? Buck Unless 50, yeah. Got to keep it a buck 50, though. Yeah, man. I ain't gonna change.
That's usually what your dates usually consist of, right? $1.50 like
spending $1.50 on that dollar menu at McDonald's.
On that dollar menu, get what you want. Hey, that's extra mayonnaise if you want.
That's a cheeseburger and a half. That's a cheeseburger with extra cheese.
Oof, fuck, man, you going all out? That must be someone. That's how I know you like someone. Special. If you ask me for extra cheese. Let me get some extra cheese. Like, what? Yo, Vic, you trying to waste this cheese?
And I let her get extra cheese. What? Oh, shit, it's serious.
All the cheese. What? Yo, shit, do I gotta get my grooming fit on? Yo, I gotta get no cummerbund or no cummerbund?
Wearing vests.
Ruffles or no ruffles? What we doing here? What we do? Oh, my bad. Okay, get the cummerbund, you know? But yeah, man, I think Valentine's Day, for one, is overrated. Mm. Number two, is just a way for these companies to suck all the money out of you. Because realistically, yo, it should be Valentine's Day every day. Mm. I'm just joking. I'm going to ask your wife about that.
Yo, is it true that Valentine's Day is every day at your crib? She's going to be like, fuck! Like, fuck that.
I wish it was at least once a year.
It should be at least once a year. It doesn't have a day, you know.
But yeah, man. Nah, so Valentine's Day is out there. You know, fellas, strap up. Women, get your dental dams. The last thing you want to do is have a baby on Valentine's Day. That's just a no-no. Because when the baby looks back, and be like, damn, hold on. I'm November. Damn. That means my parents were fucking around Valentine's Day. That's gross. So you don't want to know. You don't want to, like, know.
You don't want to do that to them. You don't want to know.
Yeah, you don't want
to. You don't want them to know.
And also, again, when this comes out, it'll be February 13th. Mm. And a special day in hip-hop history. Ooh. 22 years ago today, The Score from the Fugees and All Eyes on Me from Pac came out in 1996, February 13th.
Ooh.
That's a round of applause.
Ooh,
for that.
Ooh, la, la, la.
A great day in hip-hop history. Okay.
See what I did both there? You see what I did there?
That, yeah, I saw what you did there, Vic. Very clever. Very clever. Look at you. Look at you. You're evolving. Week in and week out. Wow.
Slow clap.
But yeah, man. The Score and All Eyes on Me came out, and yo, The Score went diamond, yo.
Damn. Diamond.
And Pac, well, I'm sure that shit went diamond because both of those albums were fire. So round of applause for that. So you might hear that in the background as well, just so we give a little. Is it homage, Vic?
Or I say homage, but who knows?
I say homage. Who knows? I see some people say homage, and I'm just like, that just don't sound right.
That just sounds a whole lot of extra right there.
Like a whole lot of extra.
Yeah, yeah.
Dude, we could do a lot of this. We could flip this into a ludicrous verse. Yeah,
that sounds like Barack singing it. Like, you got a little extra sometimes, a little extra sauce on words, and you're like, nah, come on, bro.
Demasiado.
Come on, bro.
Chano de tan mucha salsa en la taca.
Cuidado, eh.
But yeah, man, hey, listen, we have a lot to talk about in this episode. Episode 56 is chock full of content.
Yep.
Okay. Stories galore. Okay. We got Trump. We got the fucking Olympics. We got all types of shit, man. This is like a Neapolitan episode. We got everything for everyone.
There's not necessarily a theme to this one. It's just all the shit.
Actually, there kind of is a theme.
Okay.
Is a theme. I guess we'll kind of get to it once we finish this.
All right.
Mm-hmm. Well, anyway, man, you listen. One thing that people are not talking about is the Olympics. And I, for one, am I okay with that? Because, listen, the Olympics to me are just fucking boring. Unless it's the Summer Olympics, I don't
know. I was just about to say that. I was like, okay, so what about the Summer Olympics? But no. See, the thing is, the Winter Olympics have been historically absent of POCs. there hasn't been a whole lot, you know, in the past, and it's getting a little better nowadays, but I do have a confession to make. There is a sport that I like watching consistently on the Winter Olympics, and that's curling. I don't know what it is about it, Ed. It's
neither. I don't know why.
It's just one of those things. I don't know why that's a thing for you. It's just one of those things that, like, you just watch, you're like, oh shit, they better knock the other stone out of the circle. And
listen to what you're saying. Say that one more time, Vic. Say it again. Say it slower this time so that people can hear it. Just say it one more time. One more time so everyone can hear what you just said.
Anyway, there's just something about it. It's kind of like, I mean, I don't watch darts, but it's kind of like darts on ice.
Darts. Oh, yeah. Fuck.
So I know it sounds horrible. I know I'm not doing it any services, but I can't stop watching it, man.
Why do you love curling? Just listen, you don't understand. It's like when the other block hits the other block.
It's called a stone, Eb. It's called a stone.
Oh, I'm about to have the curling Twitter attack me. Like, what? Yeah. Don't you ever disrespect. They're called stones.
You're like, yeah. Anyway,
fuck you.
I don't know. That's the only thing that I do enjoy watching. Everything else is kind of like whatever. But Eb, you did find something that was quite interesting, and
I love it.
Maybe we should just play it. Maybe we should just play it.
Yeah.
All right. Here we go.
Next is the Netherlands. It's probably not a newsflash to tell you the Dutch are really, really good at speed skating. All but 5 of the 110 medals they've won have been on the speed skating oval. Now, why are they so good, you may be asking yourself? Because skating is an important mode of transportation in a city like Amsterdam, which sits at sea level.
What?
As you all know,
yo,
lots of canals that can freeze in the winter. So for as long as
they don't fucking video game, like, what the fuck?
And also to have fun.
Yeah. Yo, what the fuck is Katie Couric smoking? Yo, like, yo, she is on that gelato.
You got that loud, Em. She's smoking that crazy loud because, yo, the only thing she got right is that they do it for fun. That's the only thing she got right. Like, yeah. Everything else, she's fucking bugging. Like, they have canals. Well, I guess they're at sea level as well, but they do have canals, but they don't fucking skate on that shit. She's fucking, I don't know what the fuck she's smoking.
Yo, I'm thinking, like, Katie Couric has been in news for, I'm assuming, at least 25 years, right? Isn't, like, the number one thing, at least on a reputable news source, you fucking fact check? Like, this shit just sound like she made it up, dog. Like, she was watching the Silver Surfer. I was like, oh, shit. He must be Dutch. No, he's from Holland.
You know, I'm surprised she wasn't like, you know, the reason why they're so good at skating is because they wear those wooden shoes. It gives them an advantage.
She doesn't even make any sense. She's... Like, I need to know, how did she come up with that? Like, yo, that shit sounds like a wild fucking sketch comedy. Like, oh, hey, listen, that sounds like Nike's rendition of the, you know how they're selling, you know how Nike always has those commercials where, like, they're waking up early as fuck in the morning and they're running, but in fucking Holland they're putting on their skates and shit, skating everywhere. Like, I gotta make it to the bus stop.
I'm late for work, let me put my ice shoes on.
Yo, what the fuck? Seriously, like, come on, yo, Katie, out of all people, Katie Couric, too. Like, out of all people, Katie Couric. And she sounded so, like, you know what they do? Is like, they do that shit for fun. They ice skate as babies. They ice skate in the womb. And when they come out, you know, that's their mode of transportation. Like, 90%, really?
90%
you're telling me in Holland.
Just come sliding. Oh, fuck.
Sliding. Just skating up pussy.
There you go.
Yo, what the fuck? Like, seriously, like, that's what they do. Right, once November hits, like, oh, well, there goes our walking days. I gotta go get my skates. Like, what? No. Like, it's Holland, not fucking Ice World. The fuck?
The funny thing is that a lot of people were just probably like, oh, yeah, I guess they skate in fucking Holland.
Yo, I'm telling you, someone probably went on Twitter like, hey, did you know that in Holland all they do is skate to get to places in November? From November to February?
Yo, maybe...
Yeah, they don't walk.
Maybe where I got the facts of, like, lobster screaming and fucking koala bears getting high on eucalyptus, maybe it was from Katie Couric, because that shit's fucking wild.
Yeah, imagine a country like that where, like, the only way for you to get from place to place is a skate.
Nah.
You could never get in a fight. How would you fight? Ever?
Nah.
You couldn't. This shit would look like a play.
Come here.
It'd be like the fucking...
I'm tired of pumping my skates. Come on. My legs are getting tired.
Oh my god, that's fucking... Like, literally, out of that was probably the most entertaining thing out of these fucking Olympics, because no one's watching. I mean, let's keep it a buck. No one's watching the Olympics, all right? Like, nobody is. And if you are, you're lying to yourself, because there's probably just nothing.
No,
else to
think watch. I think you're right, because as opposed to the Summer Olympics, they're only playing it like once in a while on NBC Sports, and like I guess on the weekend a little bit on NBC. But like for the Summer Games, they have NBC Sports, USA. They're covering everything. They're covering everything, and I don't see hardly any coverage. So maybe you're right. Maybe people are just not interested, and I guess that's cool with me. I don't really care.
I mean, I'm telling you, who ain't no one got time for that, dog?
We got an owl in here.
Listen, the one thing though I kind of read was that Colombia, they qualify for the Olympics for the alpine skiing in the men's slalom and the men's giant slalom and cross-country skiing along with speed skating. And I was just like, Wow. Okay, listen, the only like what, first of all, what ice is in Colombia? None of that. Like the old, and I made the joke and I'm going to have to make it again. So get the dad joke drum set ready, Vic, because the only skiing I'm seeing Colombia doing is on cocaine. Dance. Thank you. Thank you. Okay, that was too easy.
That was terrible.
You set me up. I'm going to take it, guys. Terrible. It. Okay. Oh, shit. Look at this, Vic. Look at the medals. The medals, though, Vic.
What's the medal count?
Zero. Just like I thought. Nada.
Talk about Colombia.
Ain't no winner in Colombia. Okay. Ain't no winner in Colombia unless we're talking about the cocaine. God damn it. I'm on a roll today, Vic.
Just lost like four listeners there.
Call me butter, baby.
God damn it.
Anyway, man.
Whack.
Yo, hey, your boy LeBron had to go out like a super chump.
Yeah.
Super fucking chump, yo. I can't believe this fucking clown.
You talking
man.
About
I
that
really
cannot. Going at a business sale they had in Cleveland?
Yeah, that fucking that crazy Gideon fire sale that he had. Yeah, man. Yo, that guy got rid of everyone and their mother.
Oh shit. You know what's funny, Ed? There were on all the ESPN and all the Fox News, the ones that write his dick, they were spinning it like it was like, oh, this is the fucking best thing ever. LeBron James never asked for this. Dan Gilbert was sabotaging the team by getting Isaiah Thomas. And that would be maybe more credible if LeBron James didn't have the history of only surrounding themselves with superstars.
He has a track record.
He has a track record. He's been known. He's been known to only want to play with superstars. So to go out and say, oh, it's Dan Gilbert's fault, doesn't really make sense to me.
And Dan Gilbert, how is that his fault if he went to go get literally the leading candidate for the MVP last year in Isaiah Thomas? Before his hip. So how? You got Kyrie Irving was like, I don't want to play here anymore.
Yep.
Probably because I'm getting out of this guy's shadow. And I need to move to a team where, listen, I'm going to be the guy. Because this guy's always complaining. And look at that, dog. They were imploding. Imploding. 1 week, somebody was saying some shit. They're always talking shit about LeBron and, you know, his leadership skills. Hey, is it really Dan Gilbert's fault or is it LeBron's fault?
That's what I'm thinking. I mean, literally, the only way LeBron will switch to a new team is if you tailor the team to what he wants. And fair enough, he's the best player in the league, right? Like,
I mean, he's earned it.
He's earned it. If that's what his stipulations are, you kind of have to bend your knee, right? Like, fair enough. Everybody knows that. But now all these tip writers, all these tip suckers, Ed, are out here.
Just say dick writers.
All right, dick writers, dick suckers. they're out here pretending. They're pretending like this is not LeBron's idea. In what world?
That's because you know what it is. You know what it is. They don't want to come out and say some blasphemous shit and have King James. They don't want them on their bad side. You know what I mean? He's like, oh fuck. They gotta say that, man. Like that's That's politics 101.
But it was okay. But like the reaction on like on sports news and like the fans' reactions were two different things. Everyone that's watched sports in their life, at least follows it somewhat regularly, realizes this was a disaster. This is a disaster. They said that they're now the leading candidate to lose to the Golden State Warriors in the finals.
Like, dog, they were the leading candidate to lose to the Golden State Warriors at the beginning of the season. I don't get it. Even when they had Isaiah Thomas.
So,
dog, no one's going to beat the Warriors.
I honestly, Eb, I don't know if they're going to make it to the finals.
Oh,
I don't know. Not Golden State. I'm talking about Cleveland. I don't think they're making it to the finals.
Oh. Oh, yeah. No, for sure. They might not. I think the Celtics might get in that ass.
That's what I'm thinking.
Or the Raptors might even get in that ass.
That's what I'm thinking. Like, there's a couple teams that might be able to do something with them.
Sixers might even get in that ass.
Let's not. Come on.
Joel Embiid, the way they're balling out, they you never know, man. They're playing some good basketball. But yo, listen, LeBron, straight sucker. He said, although, listen, I feel like the Lakers got a little bit better. Although I wish we didn't get rid of Jordan Clarkson. We lost Jordan Clarkson and Larry Nance Jr. Yep. They went to Cleveland, and we ended up getting Isaiah Thomas. And there's a little drama there already. And then LeBron ended up getting Rodney Hood, and I forgot who else. They got one other player that's actually a decent baller. Mm. But other than that, man, I don't see that team doing anything in the finals. At least not that team. But
I don't know if it's a great move for the Lakers, because again, Isaiah Thomas is gonna sign for just this year, and then he's a free agent, and we lost two good pieces, I would even say.
Vic, we're about to get Paul George and Giannis Antetokounmpo.
I'm just laughing. I'm laughing at how you struggle to get that one out of there. I wouldn't even have tried it. I wouldn't even try it. Yo, I don't even want him on a team just because I can't say his name.
We're just going to call him. We're like, nah, man, you got to go by your first name around
G,
here.
I'm just going to call him G.
You got to go by your first name around these parts, sir. There's too many vowels in your name.
There's too much. It's too extra. Come on.
I can't mess with that. Like, you're black and you're Greek. It's kind of rough as it is. I can't do that. We'll just call you G. We'll call you Giannis. I like Giannis.
Oh, man. But, yeah, I don't know what's going on, man. The league went upside down in one day.
And it was crazy because I woke up and it was just like, hey, guess what? I'm like, what? Everyone left Cleveland. Like, what? What do you mean?
Dwayne Wade left.
Yep. Channing Frye. Fucking Isaiah Thomas. I was like, God damn, really? Yeah. Whoa. Imagine we have that much power on a team, Vic, that you could single-handedly say, I need this guy gone, this guy gone, and this guy gone by tomorrow. Tomorrow. Well, I bet you D. Wade was like, yeah, get rid of all these fucking wanksters.
Well, me too.
Me and LeBron. Wait, what? Yeah, man, I gotta let you go. Like, man, I thought we were friends. It's business, baby. You know what it is. But yeah, man, listen, and the Lakers got Isaiah. We don't know how that's gonna pan out. Hopefully it pans out okay. But he was already starting his shit with, like, listen, I don't come off the bench.
Ooh.
You know, I ain't no fucking backup to no fucking scrub by the name of Lonzo Ball.
Yeah, I don't think he should be, though. I don't think he should be a backup.
I don't think he should be either. Listen, man, first game out, he was dropping dimes.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, Lonzo ain't doing that. Lonzo can barely hit, dog. Lonzo can barely hit a fucking 10-foot jumper with that ugly ass form that he has. Jesus Christ, man. Let me keep listening.
Hey, when they're Lakers, Eb, we don't call it ugly form. We call it unorthodox. All right.
Yes.
Everyone else has ugly form.
It's different. Until he leaves. Until he goes to the Nets or something. Yeah, then he'll be like, yo, that motherfucker got an ugly shot. Big baller never lost.
Yeah, but from one guy with a terrible hairline to a man that had a horrible hair day. Your boy, your main man, Donald Trump, had one of the worst days.
He's not only a client, he's the fucking president.
The thing that bothered me the most about this is not that he has bad hair, because that's not what's important when you're governing, but the fact that I thought that's where the hair was coming from, the back of his head. I thought he was doing the comb over from the back to the front and swooping it up.
Nope.
It turns out that's not what's going on.
Yeah, I don't know what the fuck that was.
So you guys got to see the video of Donald Trump getting on Air Force One and his hair just doing all kinds of wild shit. Most hairdressers that reacted to it said that it was a bad glue job.
Oh, shit.
That he had a bad glue job and that it shouldn't have done that. If it was done right, it should have stayed put. So yeah. We have a president that can't even get his hair done right. Yeah.
Yo, man. This guy. You know, I was thinking, like, yo, how does Melania sleep with this guy? Like,
barely, dog, with her eyes closed.
Jesus Christ, man. How do you even, like, caress that man's head at night knowing that you might pull the scalp off?
Oh, God damn.
You savage. You're like an Indian. Just fucking my scalp. God, yo, that's fucking gross. Yeah, man, that thing was just flapping in the fucking wind. It looked absolutely disgusting. I'm like, this is our commander-in-chief? Like, yo, look at Obama. You got a fucking Caesar. You got a fucking beard now ready to go fuck your bitch. Like, and you out here looking like a straight sucker with these boxy suits and you fucking slapped on, pasted on wig. That's just disgusting.
And this is the guy that's...
I don't want that man as my president.
And this
president.
Is the guy that's been in TV for the last, like, 25, 30 years.
Not even that, Vic. This is the same guy that's out here talking shit about other people. Like, my man, you can't talk shit about other people when you look like that. You know what I mean? Like, that. I'm like, we need to write some of these jokes or some content for some of these other presidential candidates, Vic, because this guy is easy money. Easy money.
You know what? It brought back the moment that probably got, this is my opinion, the moment they got him elected of his doing and not of, you know, the FBI with the whole Hillary shit. The one thing that he did that got him elected was when he went on Jimmy Fallon. And he let Jimmy Fallon ruffle his hair. That made him look too normal.
Made him look human.
Made him look human for a second. And I can't fucking ever watch Jimmy Fallon after that. It was that, I, in my opinion, that's what did him in. That's what did him in. And he got the roots, man. He got the roots.
It doesn't mean he got the jokes, because he is not funny. Hey, guys, are we going to go die? Let's go. You want to go dance? Let's go ahead and do some lyrics, guys.
Yeah, you are a straight hater, man.
Westlaw, play me a beat. Look how you got the fuck out. Show bitch ass down. You ain't funny.
Wow, man.
Damn, did I strike a nerve? Damn, Post Malone and Jimmy Fallon, Vic, you're something else. God, man, you're going.
What?
Now you're gonna tell me? I'm waiting for you to tell me that you like that fat white guy who does the lip sync battles.
I have something to tell you, Ed.
Oh shit.
You have a lot of hate in your heart, man.
I do have a lot of hate.
You have a lot of hate in your heart. You need to set it free.
No, I'm not going to set it free at all. Not when you like whack comedians and whack quote-unquote rappers.
Oh, God.
When I told you how much I like the Snoop Lion album, where you fucking, oh, yeah, that is a great no. You're like, this shit is whack. It's fucking terrible.
Shit was whack and terrible. What can I tell you?
Yo, listen, they have one song on that album that's like a straight
EDM
song.
They got no songs on that album. They have no songs on that album.
Nah, he got some
fire. They have a whole bunch of trash on that album.
It's the Snoop D-O-double-G-Z.
I'm good. I'm good.
You know, it's crazy because I was listening to that album. I was like, yo, you really can't go from doing the Snoop Lion album to talking about fucking shooting people.
And he did. And yeah, he did.
Yeah, let me go back to my niche. Shit ain't working for me. God,
oh,
man.
Shit.
Well, whatever. But hey, listen, we weren't the only people clowning Trump, dog. Your main man, 100 grand pots and pans. Okay.
who are we talking about here? Apparently I have a lot of main men, pots and pans.
The young Potsticker, Kim Jong-un, came out and was trolling the shit out of Donald Trump.
Wait a second. Wait. I can't let you drop that dick and not let me marinate over it for a second. Did you call him the young pot sticker? Jesus Christ. Ooh, continue.
Oh, man. Listen, man, I feel like Kim Jong-un has like an L.A. barber fly out to North Korea every couple weeks to give him a shape up, dog, because he looks like a straight up fucking hipster.
So what did he do to kind of?
So he was trolling the shit out of Trump because he saw the story of how his hair was just flapping all in the wind with, you know, just out there looking like a stray sucker. And he trolled the shit out of him. He took a picture of his hair flapping in the wind, staying stuck right to his fucking head, Vic. Damn. That is, listen, to me, that's comedic genius 101. That's shots, dog. That's the takeover right there.
See, that's, unfortunately, the shots that might be taken are fucking nuclear bombs, dog. That's the problem.
He literally just put Donald Trump on the Summer Jam screen and was just like, what's poppin'? You see this right here? These follicles don't fly away. These are real. These are real right here.
Damn, man.
Listen, that's what I'm saying. We can't have a fucking president out here looking like a straight goober, man. Like, the fuck? Long ass ties, these big ass suits, fucked up hair, disgusting skin. Like, god damn, man. Like, in no, that guy would be a car salesman, Vic, in a normal world. And instead, he's the fucking president of the United States.
In a fair world.
Yeah. Oh, man. Anyway, Vic, let's go ahead and take a quick little break, and we'll be right back.
I'm Seth in the Sweats.
I'm Easy in the Suits.
And you are now listening to Sweats and Suits Podcast. Now catch us every Monday, this Monday, on iTunes, SoundCloud, Google Play Network, Spreaker, as well as UrbanMogulLife.com. Shout out to the moguls.
Now give me two claps and a Rick Flip.
Woo!
Well, hey, listen, let's keep on going with these whack-ass politicians. So, Vic, when you are lobbying against prostitution...
When I do it personally?
When you yourself go to the Pasadena courthouse and you start saying, like, these hoes need to get off Colorado Boulevard.
Never. I would never. Those women have a job, a place in this community. Anyway, continue.
So, a Utah lawmaker who actually voted for tougher penalties for prostitution resigned.
Must have got caught with a prostitute.
Listen, when you know what it is, Vic. If you're out here trying to stop prostitution, chances are you catching cops in prostitution. 9 times out of 10. And yeah, that's exactly what this fucking clown was doing, man.
Let me guess, a Republican?
Yes, right. GOP. John Standard resigned last week amid allegations that he used taxpayer money to pay for hotel rooms to hook up with an online escort. Like this shit shouldn't even be a story. And the funny thing is, like, I was reading this, and they actually caught up with the call girl. They actually caught up with her. Her name was Bree Taylor. Saying that the former GOP representative John Standard paid her $250 for sex twice. In my mind, I was like, damn, boo, you out here lowballing yourself. You getting $250
for a politician?
To fuck a politician? Yeah, you know, you must.
Yeah, but then them loose lips, Eb. Them loose lips.
Listen,
that's why she gets paid so little. She ain't professional, Eb.
You know what it is? You know what you're going to get when you're paying that. I don't know what the going rate is, but I'm just saying, like, $250 sounds like, it doesn't sound like enough to keep your mouth
standard shut. Right, that's what I'm saying. Like, okay, you're probably paying that for, like, any regular guy's paying for that probably, right?
I mean, for an hour,
like, let us know what the going rate is, y'all know. But I imagine for a non-disease encrusted
god woman, encrusted
encrusted, yeah. Cause that shit's probably crusty, dog. Anyway,
yeah, that's your nickname in the street.
encrusted. You know, I bet that runs around $200 at least. At least.
Yo, this cheek looks.
So $250? What is he doing? What is he doing? He can get. God, he can get probably. Well, it is Utah, though. I was about to say he could get probably a high end, you know, escort and keep that shit quiet because that's what they
like
do.
This guy was using. That's what this guy was using petty cash, dog, to pay for a prostitute. Like that's. I'm more concerned.
He was probably using his stipends. I think that's. I mean, there's no way you can get away with like using petty cash like that because that's you need receipts. So he was probably using his stipends, which I imagine he gets on, you know, official travels.
Oh, and, shit! That's what is that? Know, is that like a voucher? Like when you.
So stipends is like whenever you get sent on a work trip. They give you money for food. They give you money for lodging, and exactly. So I imagine he's just like, okay, I just I'm instead of eating my double cheeseburger, I'm gonna get a prostitute.
again, the funny thing is, this call girl was 39 years old. Listen, let me tell you, I don't even have an issue with. I have an issue with the guy, right? I get it, I understand it. He's a piece of shit. Chances are, that's what most of these guys, most of these Republicans, mm-hmm. most of these conservatives, they all have these fucking deep dark fantasies that they just, you know, most of them are child molesters. A lot of them are fucking cheaters. You know, all that good shit.
All that bad shit.
But my problem is. Yo, you're a politician, my man. Like, why are you catching the low end call girls? $250? Like, come on, dog. Like, you really think a $250 call girl is gonna keep her mouth shut about having sex with you?
Exactly. That's just,
you gotta go to the high end, yo. High end. What is your problem? Like, this chick said for $250, she gave him a blowjob and she had sex with him. Like, that's a deal. But. What my thing is, like, you know, hey, listen, you pay, you know, you get what you pay for, right?
True. See,
and this is what you got.
Personally, Ab, in my opinion, it's none of my business that he has an affair. It's none of my business that he hires a prostitute.
Well, hold on,
I'll tell you.
No.
Until
it should be because he's
hold on, until he's using taxpayers' money, and until you go ahead and push for legislation that are against what you're doing, are exactly the opposite of what you're doing with your regular life, then it's my problem. And that's what's going on here. If he was just, you know, if he just liked prostitutes and he wasn't legislating for laws against prostitutes or raising minimum penalties, then I wouldn't have a problem. But he is, and I do. What he does in his own bedroom, what he does in whatever bedroom, that's none of my business, usually.
Well, when you're a politician and your views are completely the opposite and hypocritical to what you said, no, yeah, I make it my business. But I also make it my business that, yo, this girl has no ass, like none whatsoever. And
$250,
but $250, this guy got anal, a blowjob, and
Jesus Christ.
Yo, this girl is just like, she had a LeBron James set. I was like, here, everything, you get it off. You
want. everything for nothing.
Yeah. Yo, man, again, just another example of these corrupt fucking politicians, these hypocritical individuals. Man, what else would we expect, dude? What else would we expect?
You know, he's probably a repressed Mormon, because it is Utah. But I never say I never agreed to that being an excuse. That's just something that you chose. So fuck you. So he withdrew, right?
He resigned.
He resigned. And I guess we'll have to wait to see what happens, man. From what I heard, is that he's not gonna have to go through an ethics investigation because he did resign instead of it coming out. While he was still in office.
Fucking clown.
Yeah.
Anyway, speaking about clowns, Vic.
Oh.
I know you've been waiting for this one for quite some time. And hey, listen, it shook up the world about 12 years ago. And it's about to shake up the world again. Yo, the Jersey Shore is back. And I'm thinking to myself, who asked for this? Who asked to see the Jersey Shore in 2018? Like, nobody wants to see that. Nobody gives a fuck. And I'm like, aren't like half of them Puerto Rican anyway? Like, what the fuck? Like, no. Not even real Italians.
Are they? What? I never heard about this.
I heard like, was it like the little stocky one with the mohawk? I heard he was like Puerto Rican or some shit like that. And then like Snooki's like Egyptian or something. I don't know what the fuck she is, but she's not Italian.
You know what? I always saw her and I was like, she don't look Italian.
I think she's Armenian.
She looks like Armenian or like.
So off top, they're not even real. Not even. But I'm like, who the fuck is asking for this shit?
Ed, obviously you haven't been following my Twitter account.
Obviously.
Hell no. I cannot stand those guys. I cannot stand any of them. Any of them. Not one of them.
Yeah, I'm like, there's just... My thing is like, yo, there is way too much TV out there for you guys to even be relevant. There's too much Netflix. There's too much Viceland. There's too much fucking Fire Stick. Who wants to watch a bunch of 37-year-olds at the Jersey Shore house again?
But Ed.
Hey, yo, Vinny. You want to go to the club? Come on.
Ed, you're forgetting what network it is, Ed. You're forgetting what network it is. It is the new king of trash TV. MTV?
God.
Yeah, like, all they play on their network is trash TV.
Basura. Pura basura.
Yeah. Again, what do they play? They play.
But who wants to play?
What the fuck? It's all... it's just fucking terrible shit.
My team mom.
My team mom. That's the one I was looking for. My team mom. Catfish.
I mean, no, hold on. Catfish is doing a lot.
Catfish
is a pillar in the community, Victor. Catfish.
It's not even real. It's a stage show.
I know. But again, this is real life. There's a lot of people out here getting catfished.
Get the fuck out of here. All right, whatever. Yeah, that's your fault.
Although, I mean, now in age, if you're getting catfished. Dog, we had a story about a guy who got catfished out of, like, $5,000? Remember, he was sending her money over and over. Imagine had he seen one episode of Catfish, he would have been, maybe his spidey senses would have started tingling. And he's like, maybe I'm getting fucking catfished out here in these streets.
Nah, but Ed, you're thinking that men think with their brain and not with their dick.
He didn't even see this girl for a year. That's too long for me.
He was anticipating getting some good old pussy and never got it. But he ended up paying a whole lot.
He didn't get it. But anyway, man, so the Jersey Shore is coming back to MTV. And as I said earlier, I don't know who asked for this. Who's honestly trying to watch the Jersey Shore? A bunch of washed up Italians. And again, I don't even think they're Italians, Vic.
Aren't they like 45 at this point?
I don't know, man. What's the guy's name? The fucking
situation.
The situation. That guy's going to jail for 15 years for tax evasion. So what? Like, wait. Yeah.
Are you serious?
Yeah. That motherfucker went to jail for tax. Oh, he's going to jail for tax evasion. He's facing up to 15 years.
Damn. You know what? He's the worst one. So good riddance. Fuck. He's the worst out of all of them, man. Like him. And what's the thick chunky one? Not even chunky. I'm giving her some leeway. Yeah, what's the chunky one?
The Puerto Rican guy.
What? No, the chick.
Chick.
The chunky chick. The fat chick. You make me say it. What the fuck is her name?
Snickers.
Yeah, that one.
Yeah, okay.
Her and that dude are the fucking worst. I can't, Eb. I fucking can't with these people. Like, Eb, I don't like trash people in life.
God.
Much less.
But you love Jimmy Fallon. You love watching Jimmy Fallon.
He ain't a trash person.
Yes, he is.
He's a trash person. He might have trash comedy, but he's a trash person.
Let's go do some lip syncing, guys. It's me versus the guy. Quest Love need another one.
Out of here, dog.
Wow, hey. If y'all think Ev has a chip on his shoulder, yo, hit us up at Buffet_boys on Twitter. Let us know what you think it is.
Never let us step foot on that fucking show.
which old girlfriend? Which old girlfriend you think Jimmy Fallon fucked the Vibs? Huh? Which old one, huh?
Jimmy Fallon fucking none of my girlfriends.
Hey, he took your girl, what?
Jimmy Fallon?
Man, you mad as fuck. Anyway.
Fucking sound like Bubbles the Clown.
Wow. Yeah, you have some problems. You have some problems.
Coming from the guy who fucking who writes fucking threatening messages to Eminem online and then fucking changes his screen name so no one doesn't know who it is. Fuck out of here.
I've never done that. I've never in my life, not once, have I ever made a threatening anything to anyone.
I know where you live, Marshall. Like,
I fucking hate him. I'll look at this. I hate him. I think he's whack. I think he's fucking personality. He's fucking shit.
Wow, but you have Hey, who wants to take up collections and bets on which one of Vic's girlfriends is Eminem fuck?
Touche.
Anyway, man, listen, no one gives a fuck about the Jersey Shore. Please don't bring this back. And if you're watching the Jersey Shore, you're the problem.
Yep. You're the reason they're bringing it back.
Yeah. Because I can't honestly see somebody say, oh, yo, what's coming out next week? The Jersey Shore. No, there's too much love and hip-hop's out there, Vic. There's too many cities.
Oh, God.
There's too many cities of love and hip-hop for anyone to care about Jersey Shore. Oh, man. Hey, real quick, PSA from the Buffet Boys, okay? This is the scam alert.
We have that now, what?
Yeah, we got that now, yes. We're getting paid. We're listen, shout out to the sponsor, Life Alert. Oh, yeah, it's for old people. LifeLock. There you go. Yo, man, hey, for all y'all out there who got Netflix, make sure you're not getting scammed because these motherfuckers are getting clever, just getting very clever, man. They're sending people emails with essentially letting you know that your Netflix account has expired and they're asking you to re-enter your payment information, and that's how you get scammed.
And then you get ganked.
Hey. What you mean? Wait a minute. I don't even go to the crack. What the fuck's a Cracker Barrel anyway? What is this? I don't even like saying the word Cracker Barrel. It just sounds too racist to me. I would never step foot into a Cracker Barrel, sir. Well, it says here you racked up about $1,500 worth of pot, sir. Yeah, man. Yo, listen, a report came out last week, actually, that the new scam involves Netflix and people who have Netflix accounts. And they send you an email letting you know that your payment was revoked and to go ahead and enter your information. Once again, so
classic scam.
That's a great action. Listen, I gotta give it up. That's a great scam. That's probably
it's known as a phishing scam, Ed.
Yeah, I love it.
That's garbage. I love phishing. Anyway, no, yeah, that's some wild shit, man. So you just gotta be careful, yo. If ever in doubt, if they say you need to pay something, go straight to the website and directly. Don't go to a link provided in the email. Always go directly to the websites, and if it says you have an outstanding balance, do it then.
Yeah, you know what, Vic? You were privy to this years ago when they had that Facebook phishing shit. And you remember back in the day when people were just posting some wild shit? You'd be like, oh, whoa, yeah. What the fuck? like, yo, is this really Victor? Like, Vic, why are you putting up fucking
not
dog
me,
porn?
Sir. Not me. That's not me. Damn, you try to put, you really try to get my name out there, dog. Hey, you know the NSA listens to our show. You need to be careful.
So yeah, man, I remember a few years ago when there's that Facebook phishing shit was happening, where they would send you a link and tell you to re-enter your password because it was locked. Mm-mm. And you would put it in and it would get your shit and you think everything was all gravy. You'd go right back to it, no problem. Come to find out that was how people were getting phished. And if you looked at the actual link, it wasn't facebook.com. It was like facebook13.net or some shit like that.
It was like close, but not quite.
Yeah, and if you didn't pay attention, you wouldn't know. And listen, same thing's happening here, folks. Be careful. Except on this one, they're not just posting like fucking some wild ass, you know, animal porn. Nah, like, God damn. Taking your money, taking your bread. So shit. Listen, that was that was brought to you by LifeLock. yo, man. Listen, let's keep this jail train on the roll, big. Let's not stop here.
You want to talk about your boy, Ed? You want to talk about your boy? The main man. Pots and pans. Jared Fogel. You want to talk about him?
Jared fucking piece of shit Fogel. Yeah, man. Hey, so last week a report came out that Jared fucking Fogel. That's right. You guys remember him as the fat guy who lost a gang of weight on Subway, but at the same time was trying to have sex with six-year-old girls.
Yeah.
Who's currently in jail right now. Came out and said that the current judge who's dealing with his case is biased because she has two teen daughters. Mm-hmm. And so is right now looking to appeal and see if he can get a different judge. And I'm thinking in my mind, I'm like, hey, fuckface. No, she's biased because you're a piece of shit. It doesn't matter who you get on there. Any decent human being is going to be biased towards a fucking pedophile, whether you have girls or not.
This is the Trump defense. Remember when he when he was saying that a Latino judge can't preside over his case because he's biased, because he's Latino?
Because he's Mexican. No, because he was Mexican.
Because he was Mexican. No, excuse me, because he was a Mexican.
Mexican descent.
He was a Mexican. That's what he said.
He was a Mexican.
Yeah, there's a difference. In the wording, there's a difference when certain people say it. But, yeah, it's just that same logic. And to be fair, I mean, not that I want to be fair to him, but to his lawyer, that's what he's supposed to do. That's what his lawyer's supposed to do, right? But I always wonder, like,
how do you work that angle, though?
And that's because that's the only hope. That's the only hope to throw out the case and start it all over again.
Yo, I hope this guy is getting mad olive oil in his ass. Like, day in and day out.
Oil, vinegar, salt, and pepper?
Get that foot-long loaf, piece of shit.
Yeah.
But, yeah, I'm thinking, honestly, how do you even come up with that defense? And who in their right mind would be like, yeah, you know, I'm going to go ahead and because, yeah, you know, I have two daughters, and yeah, I guess I could be biased. No, piece of trash. It doesn't matter whether I have two daughters. Like, I don't have any daughters, and I still think you're a piece of shit.
Yep.
Like, there's no bias there. You're just a disgusting pedophile and a disgusting woman. And I, for one, would just throw that out and say, if you come at me with some more bullshit, I'm going to give you another 10 years for wasting this court's time.
Even though you're not a lawyer, you don't know if you can do that.
I mean,
you're not a judge, you're not a lawyer.
There's a Meek Mill's in jail, and they were trying to have him do the fucking remix to I'm Bending. Why the fuck can't I give this guy another 10 years for being a piece of shit? You know they're saying he was facing 50 years for the shit that he was doing? Yeah, because he pled guilty.
It should be more than that.
He got 15. Complete, man.
There's something wrong in this world, man, where, like, young kids get arrested for some bullshit and get 15 years, and then this guy gets to fucking touch little kids, use his position of power, because that's what he was doing. He was going with his charity, with where little kids would be. He would take advantage of the situation. And he only gets 15 years? Man, something wrong in this world. But that reminds me of, I mean, this week, something got reintroduced into the atmosphere, and it really bothered me, because this is a person that I admire their work, and I'd never heard this before, but Quentin Tarantino is out here defending child molesters.
Yeah, you make QT, and listen, a perfect example where you need to separate the art from the person. At least
it's hard, though, man.
Yeah, man. You start thinking about it.
But so you was talking about what's his name? What's his fucking fuckface's name? Fucking Roman Polanski, and defending his fucking actions of also catching a 13-year-old, and Quentin pretty much said, like, oh, well, you can't, you know, you can't expect these 13-year-olds that want it, or something like, what do you, he said something along those lines, that these 13-year-old girls that want it.
That just sounds so fucking wild, dog. Just listen to that. Like, he basically said that he had to, you know, he had to say he was accused of rape. And he had to make sure that he was, that he, like, listen, tenemos que estar claros. Estamos diciendo, okay? Claramente, quiero que todos sepan, all right, that he had sex with a minor. That's not rape. See, to me, when you use the word rape, you're talking about violent, throwing them down. It's like one of the most violent crimes in the world. She wanted to have sex. She dated the guy. So because it's statutory rape, it's not rape to him. And this 13-year-old wanted to have sex with this slimy-ass 60-year-old.
You see, if you're using that argument of statutory rape at, like, 17, where they're almost 18... maybe I can wrap my brain around it. I still don't agree with you because you're not an adult. But
Tiger,
you hear me?
Tiger.
But, you know, I can get my mind around that a little easier. I still won't agree with you. But when you're talking about a 13-year-old, there's a fucking child. There's a fucking little child. And it's just nasty. You're nasty for that, Quentin. Nasty. I don't know. I don't know if I can watch his movies the same way. I have a high opinion of his place in cinematic history. Like, he is, in my opinion, he's my favorite director of all time. Or was, at least. But I don't know, man. Like, it's hard, man. It's hard when this shit comes out. And you're just like, what do you do? Like, I can't defend him.
I think the most troubling thing is when someone has a perception and a view of that, chances are that they may have dibbled and dabbled in some way.
Exactly. And that's why it's hard. Not like, if it was just like, okay, he said something that was not as, like, wild and what most normal people, like, will agree is, you know, outrageous, it's probably because he doesn't find it bad. And if you don't find it bad, you're probably doing it.
Yeah.
Like, I didn't find it bad smoking weed a long time ago. So I did it, you know? So I did it. So, to me, it just seems like, if you're going to be outspoken about that,
you're open to it. You're open to it. Yeah.
You're at least open to it. And that's just as bad. That's nasty.
There's no
you're
way
nasty that
you can
motherfucker.
Flip. You can't flip a 13-year-old wanting to have sex with a 60-year-old man. And think that that's okay.
The only thing I could think of why he said this, other than this is his feeling, is that he was on a Howard Stern show. And if you're familiar at all, the Howard Stern show is very known for saying really outrageous things. Really out there, like, banana shit. So,
but that's his truth, though. So it doesn't really matter.
I mean, yeah, that's the thing. So I don't know. It's difficult, man. I don't know if I'm gonna be able to watch anything like this. And if something comes out on Quentin, I won't be surprised. Now.
Damn, he could have just kept his fucking mouth shut. But you know what? I guess it's better that he did come out.
Yeah, I don't want to be supporting somebody who's been fucking being a grimy ass motherfucker like that. Everybody, yeah. 2018 ain't coming off to a good start, Ed.
Damn, man. Jesus Christ. Well, anyway, Quentin, listen, man. Cut the bullshit. If you're going to come out so we all know. And stop watching your movies. Or at least put the movie out before you come out.
So we can enjoy it before we feel bad about it.
So we can enjoy a dope-ass movie. But damn, it was dope.
I forgot about the things he said about the kids.
At least I saw it.
Anyway.
Hey, well, Vic, do you know who Carema Lashandra Brown is?
I do, because I sent you the story.
Please let her
listen.
Carema out here. Carema is out here living. I mean, in
Ingenious. Your best life.
Ingenious. All I know is that this Pennsylvania woman, Reba LaShondra Brown, had 78 doses of LSD, cocaine, and methamphetamine, and a fucking glass pipe stashed under her weave, Vic. Weave.
Damn.
Yo. First of all, listen, I was under the impression that when women go to jail, they have to, you gotta get rid of that. Like, you can't go into the jail until you take your entire weave out. Everything. You going natural as can be.
See, I was under the same impression, so my very next conclusion was that it was a really good weave.
I mean, it could have been some good bundles.
It must have been an excellent weave. So they wouldn't check it, I guess. So it would look natural, at least, right?
But what I'm saying is, the minute you get in there, you got a strip, and you got your, hey, listen, the extensions, the tracks, everything. Loop. Can't believe you just put it in yesterday. Gone. So how the fuck did you let a girl in there with a weed with all those drugs? That's a lot, dog. 78 doses of LSD, coke, and meth, and a glass pipe?
It was like 6 ounces of coke, too.
God damn, yo. Like, that's...
Yeah, as JC said,
you are the talk of the town.
By the OZM. God damn.
Damn.
But I mean, it's funny because the way that this went down actually is, so she got processed, she got booked, she got put in, and apparently some snitches.
Yo, that's whack.
Started acting funny, right? Started acting erratically. So the jail started investigating what was going on, and they were like, finally they ratted on her. They're like, look, it's her that has it, and you need to go look at her because she got it all. So they went and go get a warrant, which I didn't know you have to get a warrant for someone that's in jail, but apparently you do.
Yeah, me neither.
You have to get a warrant, and they searched her. And the first time they searched her, she had nothing on her. So she had it hidden real good, I guess. God knows where. God damn, I just thought of that. Yep. God knows where she put that. But so they were like, fuck, what happened? So they searched the very next day again. And then that's when they caught all that on me. This shit is bananas.
I'm just bugging. So apparently they booked her. They got her in. No problem. I mean, you're right, Vic. That shit must have looked there. That hair must look natural as well. She walked up in there. No issues. And apparently, like you said, the only way that they found out that she even had it was these two fucking snitches who were acting erratically, acting a little crazy out there, dropped a dime on Carema. And they provided the popo with a note that was written by Carema, which said, "You bitches sound bored. Get on my level. LOL. Please conduct yourselves in a discreet way. Just say I love you when you figure out what I'm talking about."
Dang! I love you.
Yeah. Carema, and so they came out a couple days later with the warrant and went through their hair, and they said that Brown was shaking and trembling. Okay. However, I was like, why would you even have to say that? She was trembling. Listen, I've dated my fair share of black women. Okay. One thing you don't do is you touch their hair, so I can understand why she was trembling in the first place. And he's like, "Listen, you're gonna fuck my shit up." But alas, Carema, you had that ooey.
She got got.
You had that contraband. And you know what? I can't even feel. I'm not even mad at this. Like, I gotta applaud the young lady for doing what she had to do.
Well, you can applaud her, but she just got 17 more felonies on her. Because So anytime you bring contraband into a prison, it's automatically a felony. Automatically, no matter what it is, you can bring an extra seasoning packet for ramen, and that should, if it's illegal, that should get you a felony.
God damn. That's crazy, dog. It's fucking whack. But anyway, dog, whatever. Listen, I salute you, Carema. Stay strong, boo. Yo, man. Speaking about jail, you know, I got a couple of these stories that you sent me, man, and I found one very, very interesting. You know, the one thing that people say about Americans, right, is that we're fucking lazy as a whole, right? Okay. That we're just a lazy fucking country. We're fat, we're obese, and we're always looking for convenient shit, and we're just fucking lazy and we don't work. And some of that might be true, you know.
Okay.
But in other countries, Vic, you know, we work a standard, what, 8-hour shift. Sometimes we work overtime. Yep. We work 10 hours and we come home. We talk shit like, ugh, I work 10 hours. Leave me alone. What the fuck? I'm trying to bring money to the house. I'm bringing in the bacon. But in Asian countries, mm-hmm. and in this case specifically South Korea, mm-hmm. yo, these motherfuckers have a legit issue with being overworked. Sometimes working upwards of 14 to 16 hour days.
Yeah.
Every fucking day and not getting paid overtime. Like, they're not like out here, you work 14 hours, right? And you're gonna get burned out,
yep.
at some point, yep. right? I've seen a gang of people that do OT day in and day out, and at some point they get burned the fuck out. They're falling mm-hmm. asleep. Not in South Korea, Vic. In South Korea, that's the norm.
Yeah.
That's like yeah. Yo, how many hours did you work? 12? Like, listen, you know what it takes to work here. And if 12's all you got, then you have to find yourself somewhere else to work. So, a report came out that South Koreans are Mm-mm. going to these retreats, but this retreat is essentially a jail so that they can get peace and quiet.
It's a jail themed resort. It's jail themed.
Jail, whatever, dog. They're literally in a cell with a cot and a small window in, I don't know what, no more than 20 square, not even, maybe like 15 square feet, if that. Imagine how much work you gotta do, Vic, to where you gotta say, hey, you know what, man, I need to go to jail. Like, there's just so much, there's so many other things that you could do, and that's literally bringing peace and tranquility to these people.
I'm so tired, I just need some jail time. You know,
yo, listen, I was thinking like, okay, listen, that must be a plush fucking jail, because yo, you come out here to these double buildings over here, towers. These twin towers in LA. Yeah, my man, you gonna wanna go right back to work to 14 hours and be like, nah, I'm good.
And that was my first thought when I started reading this article. I thought immediately the prison culture in South Korea must be much different than it is here.
Yeah.
Cause here, no matter what you do, there's one thought that always gets thrown your way. If you find out like, oh shit, I'm gonna go to jail on Thursday, your friends are going to tell you, don't drop the soap. And that's a funny thing, right? Don't drop the soap. That's, yeah, I know. You don't got to tell me. I'm fucking scared about that. But in Korea, it must not be that way. They must get treated with some kind of respect or something. Because that sure as hell doesn't happen out here.
And like I said, in Japan, actually, mm-hmm. I'm not sure if you ever heard of this, was a term called karoshi.
Karoshi,
yeah, it's these individuals who are so overworked that they commit suicide.
Oh shit, they commit seppuku.
Yeah, whatever that is, I don't know.
I think that's what it's called, seppuku, or oh no, that's when you dishonor yourself and your family. That's something else. Anyway, well, go ahead. Continue.
Karoshi is suicide due to overworking yourself, and it's a huge epidemic in Japan. And currently in Japan, they have the highest suicide rate. And this is just from people who are making fucking iPhones, Vic. Like, straight up. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, the way it works is, you know, here, you go to a factory, you work, you come back to your house, you deal with your wife, you deal with all the other shit, and you go to sleep, you wake up, you do it all over again. No, man, these guys in Japan and South Korea, what they do is they work 14, 16-hour shifts, and they sleep in the factory. The factory actually builds cots and rooms so that these people, and they live there 5 days a week, mm-hmm. and on the weekend they go home.
Yep.
But for the first 5 days of the week, they work there 14 hours and they sleep there. And it gets to the point where they get so overworked that they essentially go crazy and they just fucking kill themselves. And that is fucking wild.
Well, not only that, sometimes they accidentally kill other people, because there was actually a famous situation where a factory that's famous for making the iPhone actually burned down because someone wanted to commit suicide that way. And it just so happened that it fucking burned the whole factory down, and there's so many people living there and working there that they got trapped in a room and it killed a whole shitload of people. So this shit's bizarre, man. Like, but back to the point of wanting to go to jail, it's just wild to me. Like, I don't know. They must not be listening to the Buffet Boys, because goddamn. Actually, we do have one listener in Japan, and he's a regular listener. And I check the analytics. I check it. He listens every
week. We actually got some listeners in Nigeria, Vic. Woo! I don't know if that's Obama or what. However, no, that's Kenya. He's from Kenya. I keep thinking he's from Nigeria. Yeah, he's from Kenya.
You're fucking everything up, Eb. He's fucking from everything Kenya. Up. There you go. We lost like 10 more listeners, Eb.
From Kenya.
In Kenya, yeah.
Yo, but, you know, it's funny because I was reading that, and as I was reading that, literally the next story that I got was how all these fucking yuppies in California and all these people out here in the United States, ain't no one going to jail because they're getting overworked. You know what we do out here.
We puffed a lot.
And that's exactly what I was getting to. And the growing amount of numbers and the growing amount of people that are literally smoking weed to de-stress themselves, not after work, but at work. And it was a report that came out from the New York Times that cutthroat professionals have a new trick up their sleeves, and that's getting stoned. And I started thinking, okay, for one, you're about 20 years too late. Because motherfuckers have been smoking weed at work. Yeah, it's just been happening forever. You know that one guy where you're working and you're like, oh, yo, like, nah, hey, you can't come to work right now, dog. Like, you need to go back into your car and you need to take a nap. Like, nah, I'm good. No, you're not. No, you're not.
What are you talking about, man?
So they had quite a few stories in here. One was from Amy, a CEO of an internet startup, said, I have a high pressure job, which is the reason why I smoke weed. And she said, I'm not embarrassed. I don't think that smoking during the workday should have a stigma. If I never told anyone, no one would know. Wrong. Everyone knows that you're faded when you're faded. Okay? And that sounds like the typical pothead answer. Like, you don't even listen. Look,
like,
man,
nobody even knows, baby.
I'm a functional stoner. And
all I need is my Funyuns and my Visine, and I'm good. I promise.
Give me some Visine, give me some Funyuns, give me a Snapple, and give me all the schematics on building this new building. I got it. Like, no, okay. They said I can be functional when I'm high. First of all, those two things are oxymorons, okay? You can't be functional and high at the same time. Either you're high or you're functional. You can't be both, all right? So every story that I was reading in here was how I'm functional, I can work. No, okay? I know in your mind you think that you're good and that you can work because you're faded. No, okay? I don't want nobody. Imagine, Vic. Tell me one job that you would be okay with having the person on the other end who's actually doing the job being faded while they're doing
a surgeon.
Yes.
A dentist.
My hands are gifted when I'm blown. When I smoke gelato, that's usually when I'm in my zone.
There's jobs where I'm just like, whatever, construction. If you just
No, hell no. Yeah. You're worse, well, dog.
I hate to tell you, I've known a lot of construction workers that smoke on the job. Jesus and buildings Christ. Get put up perfectly fine.
Yeah, that's one person, dog. If you're talking about like a fucking fleet of stoners putting together a house, that shit would be the Leaning Tower of Pizza.
I'm not saying
everywhere.
I'm not saying everyone's gotta be blown at, but you got a couple in there.
Fucking doors
ain't no problems. Your baby,
fucking doors are backwards and shit. They're all inside out. Like, oh fuck, hold on, wait. Oh, is it pull or push? Oh shit, I think it's pull. Damn.
Wait, no, I got it. No, we're gonna put push. A snack no, drawer. Push. We're gonna put a snack drawer in the kitchen. No.
Hey, but what about the door? I thought it was pull or push. No. Snack drawer.
No, we're talking snack drawers right now.
Oh, okay.
Shit,
okay,
I'm going to get the snacks right now so we can see what size we need to make it.
Yo, but what about the pull and push door? Oh, shit, we could say it's that. It's a pull and push door.
Fucking anyway. Anyway. Yeah, y'all motherfuckers ain't fooling nobody. If you got a job, like, if you can code while you're smoking weed, go ahead, by all means. But
no, man, I don't trust none of that. The only person that I want to be faded, and even then, is if you work at a dispensary. I don't trust anybody. I wouldn't trust a surgeon being, I wouldn't trust a cop, a firefighter. Dog, I wouldn't even trust a fucking cashier who's faded. And I've gone to plenty stores where I'm like, oh, this motherfucker is blown.
Well, Ed, you know what's funny? Funny about that. We also saw a video, Ed, this week of a very smart sales tactic by a Girl Scout. She was out here in California posting up in front of a dispensary, and she sold like
genius
a shitload of cookies. Like, I don't think there's a better place you can put a Girl Scout cookie stand.
Or in front of a Curves. You can do that too.
Oh, no, Ed. Come on, Ed.
Listen, I'm on fire today, baby. You don't even want this, dog. Listen, when I'm on.
Everyone's opinion is their own on this show. That ain't my opinion.
Is anyway. It the shoes from downtown?
But yeah, no. This girl was really smart. The only thing that I had a problem with, Ed, is the dad was like, you know what? To her, it was just any other store because we haven't had that talk about marijuana yet. In my opinion, why even make this a big deal? Like,
who cares?
He's making it a stigma. He's making a stigma there. Like, just sell your cookies. Just keep pushing.
Yo, and you could get these people like, yo, how much you need? I got, yo, 2 for $4, 2 for, you know, what's up? It's popping. I got the Samoas on deck. What you need? Listen, I got
the Dimmins
and the Samoas.
Damn.
What? Listen, I got, both of those. I'm running out. You either go buy them right now or you're not. Like, yo, damn, this little girl's good. Like, oh, shit, damn. Yo, let me get 17 boxes of Samoas.
Damn. All right, Ed.
Like, are you sure? Well, like, all right.
What else we got here?
Well, yo, let's just wrap it up with Quincy Jones. Ooh, the more, god.
More Quincy?
Yo, this guy still talking is tapatio? Spilling tea. Messy Marv. Messy Q. You know what I mean? Quincy Jones was, again, spilling some super duper hot tea. You didn't hear it from me, but... Yo, Quincy was out here saying some very blasphemous things, and I guess they're not blasphemous if they're true. You know, so I had never heard. First of all, I never knew that Richard Pryor ever had any issues with his sexuality, and apparently that's something that he was actually struggling with, because he actually dibbled and dabbled with men. Which, hey, listen, you know, hey, to each their own, you know. Ain't no one saying nothing on this end. But Quincy Jones said that Marlon Brando fucked Richard Pryor.
God and damn.
Quincy Jones said that Marlon Brando fucked James Baldwin, Richard Pryor, and Marvin Gaye.
Jesus Christ. Not Marvin.
Like, not Marvin. That's not even tea no more, dog. That's just like, oh, well.
That's a whole tea bag right there.
That's the whole box, yo. Like, yeah. Fuck it. Here we go. And funny enough, Marlon Brando's son came out and denied the allegations that that his dad slept with Richard Pryor.
Damn.
Said that he was actually disappointed by Quincy Jones' remarks. Like, he didn't. He said he never fucked Richard Pryor. We don't know about Marvin Gaye and James Baldwin, but definitely not Richard Pryor. But I mean, Vic, listen, back in the day when them dudes were on drugs, and even now, dude, like you said, we said this probably about a few months ago on one of our episodes. These guys tour and they get pussy thrown at them like it's nobody's business.
Yep.
Right? And some have come out saying that, yo, it gets so easy that they want to try something different.
Yep.
I don't think I would ever have that problem, but apparently to some of these guys, they have sex with so many women that they want to try some butt. And
you see,
so is it really that far-fetched?
For me, the like something different would be like, oh, I'm gonna have a redhead this time. Oh, I'm gonna have a girl with blue eyes this time. Oh, I'm gonna have a girl with brown eyes this time. Yeah. That's a difference for me. But I guess this shit is fucking different, right? This fucking Hollywood shit.
Open up that Duke shoot.
Damn, dog.
So Quincy Jones also said that Michael Jackson was the original Drake, stealing everybody's music and making it his own.
Okay.
And he said that the Beatles, specifically Ringo, was straight up garbage. And that he considered the Beatles to be just regular, just a whatever group that he didn't think that he didn't know why there was such a big buzz. And you actually agree with him, Vic. Contrary to the millions and millions of people.
That doesn't matter. So what the Beatles are famous for is having a lot of number one hits. Ed, and does this sound familiar to you? They're famous for
Michael Jackson.
They're famous for being famous. Does this sound familiar to you? Drake.
Famous for being famous.
Fucking Bieber. Yeah, they're just famous for being famous. They ain't good. They're good for now. That's what they're good for. And
the Beatles have been around forever.
They haven't been around forever. They were around, and their music is infinite, like all music is. Music is around forever. Chill. That's the way it works.
Lil Pump's music isn't going to be infinite.
Hold on. So the Beatles, in my opinion, are pretty average. I mean, they have some dope songs. They even have some dope albums. But the pedestal that they get put on as the best rock band of all time, not so much to me. Not so much to me. To me, they were in the right place at the right time. They had a bunch of young girls screaming their name. And that's about it.
I don't know, man. I'm not the biggest Beatles fan. I'll admit to that. However, I can still see why they are considered such a great band. The music, there were some originators in.
There's a few things that put them better than average. There's some certain things that put them better than average. John Lennon certainly was the best part of the Beatles in his songwriting as far as lyrics and melodies, but as far as guitar playing, bass playing, drumming especially, I mean, I hate to say it, not that great. Paul McCartney was all right too, but not that great. In my opinion, there's been several musicians that deserve to be put above that.
There's always going to be that. I mean, yo, he said that Jimi Hendrix wasn't even that great of a guitarist.
And that's where no. So me and my brother got an argument about this because what Quincy said was that he had a guitarist that he wanted Jimmy to play with, and Jimmy was scared and didn't want to play with him because he knew that he was better. He knew that the guitarist was better than Jimi Hendrix. And in my head, this doesn't ring true. There's no way that it rings true. And my brother was arguing this. Were you telling me that he can't be self-conscious about not being? Yes, of course he can. But anyone that knows musicians would know, especially guitarists, they would love to play with other great guitarists or musicians.
Well,
That's the bottom line.
You can't pick and choose what's right from Quincy and what isn't based on just your opinions. It's either all right or it's all wrong.
No, that's not the way it works. That's closed-minded. That's closed-minded as fuck. No, the whole point of our show is that we're going to have opinions on things, and I'm going to have different opinions on different things. Anyway, Quincy out here talking that wild. That's some crazy shit.
Yeah, Quincy's out here talking some wild shit, man. It's crazy that he even... I'm just thinking... Why would you even come out with that now?
Like, he's about to die, dog. I think he's real sick.
Yeah, I told you. I think he's real sick. Remember, I told you that last week. I'm like, listen, either he's going for that long dirt nap or something. Because
Rashida, if you need a shoulder to cry on when this happens,
you need another shoulder to cry on.
Both on me. Date, over here.
Vic and Ab can take you out. We can play some butt golf.
You know what I mean? Yo. I will even pay 75%. And that's our show.
Rashida Jones, you wouldn't pay meal, Vic.
She got lots of money. She should be paying my meal.
God damn it, Vic. Well, you had it. There you go.
That's been our show, episode 56.
Puebla Pimp.
You can find us on Instagram and Twitter, Buffet_boys. You can also find us on our own website, BuffetboysPodcast.tk, because we can't afford the .com yet. One day. But that's it, man.
That's right. You know what it is? It was episode 56. Buffet Boys. Support your local minorities. Okay. Shout out to the UML Network. Shout out to all the dope ass podcasts on our network. Listen, we're going to be back next week, as always, podcasting for the culture, bringing more knowledge for your brain, more culture for your soul, and more bullshit for your week. It's your boy, the Salvadoran sensation, La Semilla de Marañón, Eb.
It's your boy, Vic. Peace.
Let's go. Quest Love. Play another song. Hey, let's go and do a lip sync.
Thank you. the blind stares of a million pairs of eyes, looking hard but won't realize that they will never see the peace.